Serial con man Peter Foster is today facing extradition back to Queensland. The fugitive arrested in rural Victoria after 6 months in hiding. For more, we're joined by the AFP Superintendent Jared Taggart from Melbourne. Superintendent, great to have you on this morning. How were the officers able to track him down?
David, thank you for allowing me to come on this morning. So our officers are obviously very highly motivated and very skilled, and they're able to use some of the AFP's world-leading technology and some of our specialist capability, and of course their own very significant investigation skills and intelligence to track down people like Mr. Foster. They're part of our AFP Fugitive Apprehension Strike Force. They're deliberately and aggressively tracking down fugitives like this who are living in our communities. Whether they're living in Australia, no matter where they are, they've got the ability to operate across all of Australia in close cooperation with our state police counterparts and those close relationships we share, but in fact operate globally around the world to track down fugitives who seek to hide themselves from Australia and from other countries, those fugitives residing in Australia. And it's their job to locate people like this and remove them from the community and enhance community safety outcomes.
Well, he is a slippery customer, and we understand he tried to escape when he was found. So tell us about that.
Well, I think it'd be fair to say that Mr. Foster was probably surprised by the presence of our specialist teams there at the property yesterday. I think that's probably demonstrated by the short run through the house, straight through the fly screen door, and he hid under the deck and after a short conversation came out.
Okay, so he failed to show up at a Sydney court 6 months ago. Do you think that somebody like this should have been given bail in the first place?
Oh, look, they're very much a matter for the state jurisdictions, but of course in this instance we've been able to work not only with Queensland Police very closely and Victoria Police and New South Wales Police, but with assistance from the FinTel Alliance, from our banks in Australia. People like fugitives deliberately seek to hide themselves, rely upon others, put special arrangements in place where they think that they'll avoid detection, and certainly that's not been the case in this instance.
So what happens now? What happens to Peter Foster now?
Well, he'll go through the normal process. He'll be before the courts. That'll be an extradition process that will run its course. And subject to that, he'll no doubt be back in Queensland in the near future.
Well, Superintendent Jared Taggart, we certainly know hiding under the deck doesn't work with you or your team. Good to have you on.